Hello, Saul. Are you ready to do this? Are you ready? Hi, guys. Welcome back to my channel. My name is Katrina. If you're new here, I'm so happy that you're here. In this video, we are doing an apartment tour. So this is something I have wanted to do for so long. And finally, we are going to do this. I'm really, really, really excited, if you cannot tell. So let's jump into it. Once you walk into the apartment, you are going to stand in the entryway, and it looks something like this. So here is our entryway. The first thing you will see is this nice hallway. Hello. And something I love about this apartment is the high ceilings. I really, really love the high ceilings. The first thing we have here is our rack where I keep, it's mostly mine. I keep my purses and my bags and a sweater. It's really, really nifty. It's really, really practical and helpful. It's a bit cluttered. I need to organize it, but it's really, really nice to have. And below that, we have this shelf. Sorry about the noise. The windows are open. This shelf was here when we got here, and it is just used for storage. I didn't really know what to use with it or use how to use it, so I've used it for storage. We use it for random things, as you can tell, here in the corner. We also have this shelf here, which was here when we got here as well. And I put it here. I don't really know what to do with it. I don't really like it. We use it for shoes. Sometimes I stack the shoes on top. Sometimes they go on the floor, but it's not that pleasing to the eye. So I really don't like it. But the dream is to get a white shelf here, like a 2 or 3 tier shelf where it's a shoe organizer. All the shoes are hidden inside. We'll see if that happens. We have some nice hooks throughout the apartment. This is also where I keep my bike. So story time, I had a bike before this one and it got stolen. I'm still a bit bitter about that. So I keep my bike inside. I'm a bit worried to put it outside, to put anything outside, honestly. So that's where we keep my bike. We have some random weights here. And then we have our mirror and this shelf, like for keys. Right now I'm using it for makeup and random things. So this is the entryway. I absolutely love it. This is such an improvement from our old apartment, which was a studio, which you could fit like 4 or 5 studio apartments in this apartment. This apartment is not perfect. As you can tell, we have some damage on the wall. It has not leaked with us, but with the previous tenants, it leaked, and the landlord has still not fixed it. So we are bugging him, but we'll see if it actually gets fixed. It's an eyesore, but it hasn't leaked, so it just doesn't look nice. That's Israel. You'll also see like random cracks throughout the wall. And it's not perfect. The floors are also like not that like pretty, first of all, but you also see like a lot of like gouges in the floor. Like here, you can see like random, like where it was gouged with something sharp. So it's not a new apartment. It definitely has wears and tears on it or to it. But anyway, this is the entryway. The first room I will show you is the study to the left. So it has a nice sliding door, but we usually keep the door open because the cats like to enter it by like pushing on it, and it makes that unpleasant banging sound. So we leave it open. And this room is really nice. We have 2 rooms. I'm really excited. In Israel, for 2 people, it's really nice. We have a lot of windows. We have this nice window that has the window, and then you have the shades behind it. I'll show you. what it looks like when it's open. You have these shades, which can be closed or open. We usually leave them open. I don't think I can close this one. Oh wait, here it is. There we go. So it looks like that, but then it becomes quite dark, so we like to leave them open. And the cats like to look outside, so it's nice. So these are the nice windows. We have my husband's desk. He works here, studies, like the cat scratcher, the cat bed. We also have a couch, which we prefer in here. We had it in the living room, but it just fits better here. A map and more storage. You'll see that this apartment has a lot of nice built-in storage, which is such an improvement from our studio apartment. It's really, really nice. This like bar, this exercise bar, was here when we moved in. We just left it. If I turn you guys around, we have these two items. This stand-in shelf was here when we moved in. We kept it here. Sometimes I use it as a workstation. I use it as a standing table. It's really nice. That's what I'm using it as now, as you can tell. Also, we put the lamp here. It's really nice to have if we don't want to turn on the big light. And then we have this desk, which was also here. More storage. In Israel, many times the furniture stays. Not always. Sometimes it stays. If previous tenants keep it, you just, you know, it becomes yours. I mean, it's the apartments, but you get to use it. So these items have stayed, and we just use it for storage. Another bookshelf, which is really nice. And yeah, this room is really, really, really nice to have. With the high ceilings and the extra space, if one of us needs to work quietly for a few hours, or if the cats, sometimes we put the cats in here, I don't know, we can have people over, so it's really nice to have. There isn't an air conditioner, but there are the windows during the winter. It's really nice, and the fan is here as well. So that is the study. The next room I'll show you is the bedroom, which is really minimalistic. I really like it. We have our shelf here. We bought the bed. We also brought the mattress and everything that you see here, which it's really nice. It fits nicely. We also brought this nice nightstand with us. This shelf was here, again with the high ceilings. Let me turn on the light. The fan we have here, because again, there's no air conditioning. We just have one air conditioner in the living room. So this fan is here. I still need to find a home for this vacuum cleaner. Really nice when you have pets and there are cat hairs everywhere. Also for myself, because I shed. And this vacuum cleaner is really light and really easy to use on a daily basis on the tile or on the carpet. So next to that, we have a bug zapper, which is really nice during the summer, a random chair, and then these massive built-in closets, which are really, 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 really nice. I cannot emphasize how nice it is to have storage. Like, we have an excess amount of storage for two people, so, and two cats, but. And then we have underneath, you have these drawers that slide out, more storage we use for shoes. So it's really nice. We also have this window here. So outside we have this little garden. You can see what it looks like there's an apartment building. And then here we have the aloe, we have this indoor It was an indoor plant I brought outside because our cat Saul likes to pee in it. And then the grass has died. I'm trying to figure out what I should do with this pot. I don't know yet. But this window is really nice to have. It's really accessible, and during the winter, it is nice to have a breeze. So that's our bedroom. Next, I'll take you into the bathroom. Hello, Lucy. Hi, Lucy. So this is cat number, there's Saul, the one who pees in our plants. I think he just caught a bird. Oh my gosh. One sec. Wow. Okay. So Saul caught a bird from the open window, and the bird is okay. We took it outside. It's alive. It hopped away. It was just a scary thing in the moment, but everything is fine. That will be interesting. I don't know if I will put that in the video and the apartment tour or not, but everything is okay. So let us continue. We looked at the study, we looked at the bedroom. Now I'll turn you around and show you the bathroom. So the bathroom will be here on your right when you enter. It's split into two rooms. So in our old apartment, we had the toilet and the bathtub in one room. Here it's really nice because you don't have to wait for the toilet if you have to go, or if you need to use a sink, you can. So the toilet is here. Just a toilet. And it has, in my opinion, it has serious Russian vibes. So I don't know if you guys have the same feeling, but I think it's because of the tile. So next you have the bathroom. Similar tile. It's funny, the similar tile, similar old bathtub, but it's functional. We have our cat box here. We have the washing machine. I'm doing something here with the wall. We have our laundry stuff here. The heater, which no longer works, last winter, like, blew and sparked and like totally doesn't work anymore. So that's that. We have more storage here. We have these shelves. They aren't the prettiest, but we keep cleaning supplies and then like random beauty products here, hair products. And we have more personal products in here. So it's cute. We have more storage up here, but we do not use it. We heard that there are a lot of bugs and roaches and spiders, and we're like, yeah, we have plenty of storage. Not necessary. So that is the bathroom. It's cute and charming. We also have a boiler. So during the winter, you turn on the boiler, like in Israel, if you're not from Israel. You turn this on for about 15 minutes and it heats your water. So you have a hot shower during the winter time. During the summer, it's not necessary since you have the solar panels and the water heats from the solar panels. But this is for the winter time. Sorry, I'm moving around a lot. So if we move out of the bathroom, we will come into the living room. This is my favorite room, I think. I like the study a lot too, but I love this room because of the windows. They're floor to ceiling windows. You can close the shutters and leave the windows open, or close the windows and leave the shutters open. It's really versatile. It's really, really nice. I absolutely love these windows. And I love this apartment. It's like, I know it's not new, like there are plenty of things that can be fixed and improved, but it's amazing, really. We also have the high ceilings, which are really nice. When we moved in, the wall was already painted turquoise, so we left it, we liked it. We added some of our own pictures, and then this was a wedding gift, and we added the clock recently. I don't know where to put it. I don't think it looks great here, but I'm really stuck as to which wall it should go on. So, hi Lucy. So here's our cat tower. Our cats are our children. We have this random wall here. Another thing we would like to add is like a projector, to get a projector and project movies onto this wall. That would be really nice to have. We have one air conditioning. I have my desk out here. It works. I like being next to the light, and just being in this room is really nice. So this shelf will be next to the desk. It is next to the desk, and it was here when we got here. We used it for storage. The cats don't let us keep plants on it because they pee in the pots. Guys, you pee in the pots, so that's a problem. That's why there's tin foil on this plant, because Saul pees on the pot, inside of the pot. So, I think this is how he caught the bird. He reaches, they sit on this windowsill, and he grabs the bird with his claw. You can't really open it. Like, I don't know how to clean these because we have the bar here, which can be opened, but if you want to move big items inside, but this is a problem in itself, I think. Like, cleaning wise, it's a problem to clean. I can clean it from the inside, but not from the outside. So, moving back around to the shelf, we have the basket of yoga stuff. We have the rack, which is for drying clothes. We don't have a dryer. In Israel, many apartments don't have a dryer. You have this rack, or you hang your clothes outside. We don't have a line outside, so we hang everything inside in this space here. And so it works. Then we have our plants. This plant is dying. I really wanted to do a plant video part 2, but I don't think it's gonna happen because this plant is dying. This plant has tin foil on it. And this plant is looking quite healthy, quite good. It's growing taller and taller. It also has a nice sprout. I think the name of it is elephant toothpick. That's like the slang name for this plant. So I really like it. Like, it doesn't need a lot of sun. It doesn't need a lot of water at all. It's really, really easy. So next we'll move on to this cabinet, which was here when we got here. We just keep random things inside. Some glass, some books, some board games we have in here, and then another random chair, musical notes and painting, and then my husband does glass blowing. So here he made this bowl, and he made this vase, and these other small vases, and the flowers. Like, they're really, really cool, really unique. I really love them. They're really, really special. Then we have this nice picture of Saul and Lucy. I'm just showing you everything, guys. The couch, obviously, and this nice table I got off of Facebook Marketplace. I love it. I love the color and the shape and like the height, how it's low. It's really, really cool in my opinion. And then we have the piano, which I play sometimes. And this desk was here when we got here. Sorry, table, kitchen table. This table was here when we got here. So we left it here, along with this nice shelf for storing, which was also here. This is where we eat our meals. The couch was also here. This couch, that cabinet, and this couch in here. This couch, the two couches we bought from the previous owner. So, like, why not? Then we don't have to buy our own couches. We got these couch covers, which I'm not crazy about, but that's the situation at the moment. It works. So then the last room is the kitchen. We have our own kitchen. Like, imagine moving from a studio to this apartment. It's such a big change. We've been living here for about, I think in the fall, it's going on a year. So like, I think October, November, it will be a year since we've been here. So it's really nice. So we have a fridge, obviously, an oven. In our last studio apartment, we did not have an oven. We had like this toaster oven and a hot plate where you have like two hot plates, two stoves sort of, and they just plug into the wall. You can move them around. But here we have an oven. It's really nice, plus the hot plate. It was here when we got here, so we just kept it, obviously. The fridge was here when we got here. Sometimes, like, a lot of furniture stays, you know, it's from the landlord, or you have furniture that the previous tenant bought that he or she doesn't want anymore, and you can buy it from them. So that a lot of items worked out like that for us, which is really nice. And then we have this cabinet here. We have the food, cat food. I should close this. This we brought with us, and it's really nice. It has these two tables, opens up into a long table, and it has storage on both sides, more storage. And then we have our shelving for like all our baking supplies, all of our tea, mixers, coffee, drying rack, more spices. Our dishes are here, like food, cat food, and then utensils are on this side. And then I already showed you guys our outside garden where we have our rosemary. Sadly, the sage has died. I don't know what happened. I think it's overheating because I water it every week. I religiously water these plants. So unless I overwatered it, definitely a possibility, but I think it's the heat. The random leaf, the basil, and the green onion. So that is everything, guys. That is the apartment tour. I hope that you enjoyed it. I really enjoyed making it for you. I really, really love living here. I love this apartment. And if you like this apartment tour as well, please give it a thumbs up so we can make more videos like this. Subscribe. And if you have any comments or questions or suggestions, please leave them in the comment section below. So I'll see you guys in the next one.